Michigan Hop Head Farms. We grow and provide the best hops for home brewers. And Bell's, Three Floyds, Founders, Arcadia. I'm at Beer Camp, Michigan Hops Brewing, and you're watching Mr. Liquid Red.
Welcome to the Mr. Liquid Bread Show. I am your host, Mr. Liquid Bread. Tonight's beer comes out of Plover, Wisconsin. Wisconsin is one of the big boy states when it comes to number of craft breweries. The biggest brewery that everyone blows a nut over is New Glarus. And when I think of most of the New Glarus big time beers, that's what they taste like right there. I'm not a big fan of Wisconsin beers, but this beer has set the stage for me, and I'm waiting for another brewery to step up its game. And tonight's brewery that we'll be talking about is Oso Brewing Company, and this is their Lupulin Maximus beer. And I checked out their website to kind of get a little background on how they started. It's probably one of the first breweries I've ever seen where the two people involved with creating the brewery were not a couple buddies, you know, they were home brewers. It was a guy with a home brewer and his wife. It's kind of an interesting story, kind of a, you know, romantic, I guess, craft beer story for a brewery. She is untouchable. Okay, it's time to break down the label and the cap. We do it here on Mr. Liquid Bread every show. You know I'm going to do it. And if you don't like that, you think it's stupid, you just want to hear me talk about beer, fine. Go find another beer reviewer. Go watch a Minecraft video, because that's probably more up to your speed. So the label here. I'm going to get to the little yellow part over here in a second, but typical label, you know, nothing great. It's got some pictures of some hop cones in the background. It's got a big O for the Oso, and I hope I'm pronouncing that right. It says Oso Brewing Company inside. It's got their website. Folks, if you're not putting your website on there in lieu of the street address and your phone number, this is an electronic age, man. Don't be putting your street address on there. Now, I mentioned this was an Imperial Pale Ale, which it says on the label, but if you check their website, it actually says Imperial IPA. So I'm not quite understanding why they don't put IPA on here, Imperial IPA. They're putting Imperial Pale Ale. That is a technical fault between here and their website. The website says this is a 9.0% ABV as well. Doesn't say that on the bottle at all. The cap's a black cap. It's got a white silhouette of Wisconsin, and it says Oso on the top. Kind of cool. It's good that they're doing something with the cap. No neck label. Here's the kicker, though, folks. Wait for it. There is a warning on the side of the bottle. A warning, yes, on a bottle of beer. Not a Surgeon General's warning, either. The warning says, warning, bottle may contain hop cone. Every bottle of this Lupulin Maximus beer, they stuff a full-fledged hop cone in the bottle. This is the tequila worm of beer. You know what we're going to do? Let's crack this hop cone right out, and maybe I'll even swallow it tonight. Now, the one thing when pouring this beer out is you will notice that the hop cone will sometimes come down and get stuck in the actual opening of the bottle. And it should come out. As you can see, there's the hop cone right there. And you know what? I think I got a little present. There's one hop cone. I believe I saw two hop cones fall in there, folks. So we may have a double whammy in this bottle. So this is a typical, if you want to go by the website, Imperial IPA color. It is very hazy. Copper to almost golden color. Head's nice and white and solid, holding its own. As you can see, the hop cone floating there in the top of the foam. Really cool, really cool. You're not only getting a great, harsh hop aroma, some piney resin, maybe a little bit of citra, but you're getting a lot of that malt aroma too, that caramel, kind of brown sugary smell from the caramel side. They did a really good job on this beer in not just throwing a bunch of hops in it, raising the ABV up on it, and calling it a double IPA or a Imperial IPA. So let's take a sip. Aha. Yes, this beer is exactly what I thought it was going to be. It tastes phenomenal. Again, it's got some of that brown sugary caramel flavoring from the malt, and then there's just enough bitterness there, that imperial bitterness that's not too overpowering. The bitterness, maybe a tinge of grapefruit. Really great tasting and smelling beer. This really ranks up there with some of the better DIPAs or Imperial IPAs I've had. One thing you gotta do with this too is you gotta watch out. Don't choke on the hop cone. And I don't know if I can drink one of these guys. I might be shitting tomorrow pretty bad. What the heck? It's just a vegetable, right? I might drink this. But I think it's just phenomenal that somebody out there had the balls to do this. And yes, I have two hop cones, and we will see those at the end. You can kind of see them floating around there, right there on the edge. Two hop cones. So it's almost like this. I got two hop cones in this one. It's supposed to be one. I got two. How did that happen? How do magnets work?
Water, fire, air, and dirt. Fucking magnets. How do they work?
So I'm about ready to slam this beer, as I always do. But I don't know if I want to slam both hop cones. I don't know how that's going to work in the morning. One's going to be bad enough. But let's pull one out and I'll show you. There she is, hop cone number one. Little baby blanched hop cone. Wow, still tastes great. Really blanched, almost, sometimes they get white. This one's kind of brownish color. Nice little baby hop cone. Not very big. Oop, whatever. Top to bottom, first time I'm Mr. Liquid Bread. Tequila warm beer, baby. Cheers. Hop cone went in, gone. That may prove to be a bad move on my part tomorrow morning. So again, this is the brewery you've never heard of, the beer you've never heard of, but both of them you need to find and seek out if you're in the Wisconsin area. I feel like I got that hop cone stuck in my throat. If you're in Wisconsin, if you're driving through Wisconsin, if you know somebody in Wisconsin, look for this in the summertime. This is a seasonal release, usually around June or July. If you can find it, grab some. This is a great beer. It's a great double IPA. You won't be disappointed. As soon as I know this has got the hop cone inside, oh, I jump all over this. I love seeing that hop cone get stuck at the opening of the bottle as I'm pouring it out. So if you can find this, get it. Pick it up in the summertime in Wisconsin. You won't be disappointed. Don't be buying that new Glarus blueberry, strawberry, rhubarb bullshit. Buy this and get your ass trashed. Mr. Liquid Bread says so. Bam! Yeah! Fucking crickets in the background.